Banga is reloaded. This punguza.
Yes.
Don't you think first of all una confuse Mkenya ukimwambia oh kuna punguza kuna hii punguza nyingine? Uone kidogo kuna mkanganyiko.
It's a valid question.
Mm-hmm.
Ndio. For us our trademark is punguza and we in fact our trademark came before this one.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that we did not launch.
Oh,
so we got our trademark intellectual property in 2014.
Okay.
So nikitu mekuepo. Obviously, you know, with creative ideas take time. You conceptualize it, you register it. Nafikiria sasa utafanya vipi na kabla nipate, you know, you wait for that opportune moment in your spirit. You can be and do your launch.
This is the right time.
Station kuri brands unajua watu
it takes time.
It takes time. Then you get it right.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, the name is similar. But you know, in terms of the idea, it's very different. Because babu, kuro koti yake ni ya siasa.
Okay.
It's about the referendum into punguza mzigo. Ours is just punguza initiative. And Kenya tunapunguza ni irresponsible sexual behavior. So for us, it's a youth campaign on advocacy and sensitization around health, access to health services, access to contraceptives, and even access to information. Kuju, kuna vitu vijana wajui kuhusu mambo ya relationships and reproductive health.
Why? Why? DNG, boss, we know you for big shows,
yeah.
Doing big things. Sometimes na kucheki wewe na mashori kidogo kidogo.
Lazima, lazima.
Anyway, hata kwa internet. DNG Kenya.
Oh,
first story to pale.
My ex
wife. Madem.
Yeah.
In fact, kuna ingine yama onesha dem. Kile gari, unona, kuna picture, uki click kwa images, DNG ala nyonya mtu.
Ah,
mate. Mate.
Pale kwenye Instagram.
DNG na mate. Anapeleka mate baya sana. Huyu kijana, baya sana. Alafu pia kuna story, ho, wasichana wanasema wanamkufia kwa DM kila siku. Na DNG pia samei.
Unajua mtu akimwambia Chris mtu akiweka zile macho red pale zile za love he lazima urespondi usikule mtu atio auongee na mafans wako unawakashifu unawalenga hapana be a social person.
Okay.
Because the only way to influence is by hanging around people. Ukiangalia hata wanasiasa wanakuanga kwenye ground. Wanajua nini endelea.
Okay.
And that is how we came across this initiative. Because as I was hanging out with young people, tulianza na Asole yako in 2017.
Okay.
Tukoresha vijana venye wanaanza tumia talanta, vipaji, kutafuta riziki, kwa njia inayofaa.
Okay.
Apart from that, we came across very interesting statistics. Kama sasa hivi, 33% of all new HIV infections are amongst youth.
Yeah, I was reading. You sent me that information.
Really crazy.
My goodness.
Do you know
what?
That age of contact, you know, sexually, begins at age 9.
Yeah,
that means that 9-year-olds who are documented in Kenya having given birth peer-to-peer. I'm not talking about rapes or defilement or things like that. Yani,
wow.
Mtoto mdogo na mtoto mwingine wakapatana wakapana mimba. So it's because they do not have information. Na sisi hapa kama big brothers na big sisters wao, tunataka kusema hatutazungumza nao ama we're going to pretend to like these things are not happening. The best thing is to respond. Instead of being reactive and waiting for you know the government to announce that 400,000 teenage pregnancies have been documented in per year, how can we prevent those? You know, because last year kwenye KCSN tulikuwa naona hizo shida zote, sivyo?
Okay.
We came to see all these statistics and we're like, this is something we can deal with. So we've been engaging stakeholders like government, county governments that be, you know because health is devolved, donor partners, corporates as well who are involved in medical health and these facilities. How can we give access to this youth? How can we go to the estates, high schools, campuses, talk to them? How can we give them even access to contraceptives, for example? Because they're going to have sex, Chris. Tupende tusipende peke jengo mlambezo mnyonyezi inazidi wananyonya baba. Sawa. So let's pretend, let's not pretend that it's not going to happen. It is. But can we empower young people with information so that if they decide to be sexually active, they are being sexually active responsibly. Preventing STIs, unwanted pregnancies, and 33% of these unwanted pregnancies ending up in abortions.
Why do all this?
Because I believe that leadership is not just being in parliament. I believe that using our platforms, you know, like for me, I have in total about 246,000 followers across the different platforms.
Uh-huh.
I can use my influence to engage, to communicate. We've been doing it on behalf of corporate brands for 12 years.
So now you want to do it
for social impact. Yes.
All right. Now, unajua the reason why nimeuliza, why are you doing this? Ni kwa sababu kila mtu akifanya kitu lazima akona malengo yake. Unapata kwamba mtu anaenda sehemu fulani anaanza ku promote vijana bla bla bla.
Hapo anakuwa mbunge.
Alafu all of a sudden MCA, all of a sudden mbunge.
Yeah.
DNG anaanza kushughulika na mavijana, kulikuwa na hiyo ya kwanza ya asili yako. Sasa hivi umetoka pale kupunguza. All of a sudden DNG.
Let me tell you something.
Ndani ya debe.
I've actually been doing youth work since when I was a gospel artist doing ministry.
Mm-hmm.
2003.
Okay.
So it's been a 16-year journey. It's not just now that I'm doing youth work. I've always been. I employ
you. You see,
let me tell you, there's a difference, Chris, between sherehe. You come a president wetu, jana katamaji tunajua.
Mimi sijui.
Wewe unajui? Haya, jifanye unajui, mimi najua, nimeona hata picha kwenye mtandao.
Okay.
That's not to say that he cannot be president.
Na si alikuwa na launch nini hizi hapa Naivasha wewe.
Alafu wewe Chris,
atapiga ile kitu.
Do you understand? Life is about balance, Chris. It's like saying you work 24 hours in a day. Utalaza ngapi? Utakuwa na bibi zangapi? Unakunywa pombe yako sangapi?
Okay.
Unavuta sigara yako sangapi?
Okay.
You understand?
Uh-huh.
You must balance. So, yes, I've been in entertainment, but who is to say that an entertainer should not be a leader? Who? You understand?
Man.
Chris, do not be afraid to walk out of stereotypes and break free from expectations and perspectives of others. What God has put in your heart, if today tells you, be like Ongare Madai and embrace trees and hug them.
Panda miti mpaka zikujue.
Do it.
Piga miti.
If it tells, shile unapiga. If it tells you, okota takataka, like in Rwanda, Kagame's goal has always been cleanliness.
And the place is amazing.
And he joins his fellow citizens as a president. Cleaning.
So DNG, after doing all this, I'm sure you've interacted na vijana wengi. Umejifunza nini? Let's talk about it when we come back. Sawa sawa. I love your goal. Sasa hivi okay, ukimaliza kuambia watu kuhusu being responsible sexually, being this, kutumia kinga nini nini, and then let's talk about it when we come back. Kumbuka.